Today I'm going to be using my Antares DC and putting it up against a Shimano Bantam Magnum Light from 1984. I'm going to be using both of these reels and changing every few fish and just determining the differences and what has really changed over almost 40 years of reel making. And they both make crazy sounds when you cast. You all know the iconic DC sound of the Antares. But this thing has not been oiled ever, and it makes a crazy screaming sound when you cast it. So I'll play a clip of that here. So I'm gonna go to a pond by my house and try both of these out. So see you guys there, enjoy. I'm here at the pond. I've got both reels. Let's see how they perform. So starting off, I've got a Texas Rig Senko on my Antares DC, and I've got a chatterbait on the Magnum. It's a Shimano Bantam Magnum light. I looked it up, it came out in 1984, and this is actually my grandfather's first ever bait caster. He bought it when it came out, and he's letting me use it for the video. I put new line on it. Well, let's see how it casts. That wasn't a bad cast, but it does not sound the greatest. It's also making a clicking sound when reeling. I watched that fish eat it. First cast on the 1984 bait caster. Not a terrible fish either, probably pound and a quarter or so on a calico baits, chatterbait. That is fish number one on the, I guess, antique reel, even though it's not really antique, it's an old reel. Here goes fish number one. So what I'm going to do is go back and forth every fish catch from one reel to the other, and honestly, this thing still casts pretty good. It just makes some awful sounds, and it fought that fish pretty good, so we'll see. I'm now going to try to catch a fish on my newest setup, which is a 2018 Antares DC on a Poison Adrena. I'm going to go try the Cove with the Texas Rig on my Antares, and if I don't catch anything there, I'm going to change to a moving bait on that, because they seem to not want a Texas Rig today. Here we are at the Cove. Just still got the Texas Rig on the Antares, so we'll give it a go.
Little Texas Rig fish.
Antares.
Go. Another Texas Rig Antares DC fish. So now I'm going to switch back to, I'm going to make one more cast, and then I'm going to switch back to the old reel with the chatterbait on it.
And of course, the last cast with it, I get another little one. But they seem to be stacked up right here at this log, unlike last time. So, back to the old reel. I'm back over here where I started, and now it is time, once again, to use the antique reel, even though it's not really an antique. The button is on the side of this, which is crazy. That didn't sound good. There's a fish. That might be the smallest chatterbait fish I've ever caught. This thing is like a 5-gear ratio. That took forever to crank him in, but there's fish number 2 on the antique reel. Fish is every bit of 8 inches long. So now I'm gonna catch one on the Antares again. Oh my God, that fish just slammed this little swim bait I got tied on and missed it completely. Come on, he's gotta come back. There it is. He came back for it. Another little one, but that's another fish on the futuristic reel. Just throwing a little swim bait on a jig head. Tiny one. Now I'm going back to the old reel. Oh, there's one already. There we go. First cast again with the old reel. I'm gonna make a few more casts before I change back again because I was so quick. But there it is. That sound is insane. That fish just hit it so hard. That was crazy. I don't know if you guys could see that wake. He was sitting way up on the bank. It's a little bit better of a fish, probably 1.5 pounds. Inhaled the swim bait. Look at that. Again on the futuristic reel. I think I'm gonna go ahead and go to the front pond to catch the next fish on the old reel. There's a fish. On the antique reel. Gonna go ahead and use the futuristic one again. Now I'm going to tie some bigger fish baits on, like a swim bait and maybe like a 10 inch worm or something, and see how the reels perform and try to catch a bigger fish than 1 pound. So I've decided what I'm gonna tie on. I'm gonna tie on a baby bull shad on the old reel and a ganterelle on the futuristic reel and see how the reels perform with a heavier bait on, how they perform, like just how they handle them really. I'm gonna do another lap and just give it a try, see how it goes, try to catch a bigger fish. This reel's made for big lures, so it just handles this like it's nothing. On the old reel, first swim bait fish of the day. Slightly bigger, about 1 pound. It's a small swim bait, so. First swim bait fish of this reel ever on the baby bull shad. First swim bait fish of the day. God. That's the first time it's made that sound. Don't know what that means. So last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a big glide bait on my Antares and a wacky rig on the old reel, because the old reel's anti-reverse is not good. So I wanna see how it is setting the hook with something that's not a moving bait. Go give the cove a try. I'm probably gonna catch a fish on the wacky rig on this just to test the hooks out with the anti-reverse on a weightless bait and then call it, because I am starving. Oh, one just slammed it. That little 2 inch or two that the handle moves, you really gotta hold it tight or else that anti-reverse is gonna lose you some fish. Hopefully that one will come back. It's rough casting in such tight areas with this thing though, that's for sure. There we go. Got one on the wacky rig on the old reel. Super pretty marked up fish. This thing's got its like super colors on it. It's not usually how they look in the summer like this. I guess it's early fall now though. So the anti-reverse wasn't that bad because I just used to have to hold the handle tight. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Here's the fish, let him go. But so when you're reeling on new reels, it just stops instantly. With this, it goes and it comes back like here. It goes forward and comes back at 2 inches. That can lose you a lot of fish if you're not paying attention when you go to set the hook. Well, my glide bait is snagged, so I guess I'm going out to get it. So I figured I'd set this up. See it. Now I am soaking wet, and that is the end of the video. I am now soaked, so I'm gonna go change. Thanks for watching. It was a lot of fun to compare the reels. The one from the 84 is really not bad. It's still usable if I oiled it some. It's pretty cool that they last that long. And of course, this thing is just awesome. So thanks for watching.